Okay. Now we are talking about health, and we are talking the health, talking about the health in terms of total well-being. It's not about, we are talking about just one particular aspect of your health, that physically you are fit. When you talk about health, that is your physical, mental and emotional well-being. Now, in today's scenario, when you talk about the wellness, it is only defined in terms of certain physical parameters. Okay, you do not have any sort of cardiac arrest, you feel okay, I'm fine. If you say you do not have a particular type of a disease, you are not suffering from arthritis or gout or a blood pressure, you would say you are absolutely fine. But no matter how difficult the parameters or how complicated the diagnostic tool would become, the first and the foremost parameters that you can define in terms of your health will always come from within yourself. It's not something which you need an external device to find out. That's always your own energy, your own existence, which gives you an idea whether you can proceed with your daily task effortlessly or just doing those daily tasks also requires you to drag yourself. And as you see, as you compare today's life with the life which was there maybe about, say, just 10 years ago, in terms of comfort, in terms of standard, and in terms of luxuries, we definitely stand a better, everybody is on a better ground. We all have got less physical effort to do, whether it is a professional side or it is a personal front. But in that scenario also, the people, when they were physically too involved with their domestic and their professional affairs, they were far more happier as compared to what you would ask an average individual. So there is something, I would say, a deteriorating factor which has been creeping in this scenario or in the modern lifestyle. And what it could be? How can you diagnose it? And after diagnosis, can you really take a solution, or can you really take a step to avoid it, rectify it, or maybe just, like, you know, help yourself to get over with it? So that is what we are going to not only cover, but we are also going to see to it all those questions are properly answered in this workshop. Now, when I talk about health or wellness, there are different parameters or different words which everybody would come across. I just put it in one simple line. Health is wellness, and wellness is your balance or harmony between all your different coordination of your daily life. The moment this coordination is disturbed, first, it would start affecting into your body. And when you ignored it, then it would be taking a step further to come to a point where it might be measurable into certain, you can say, problems. This could be diagnosed as some problem. Now, what way you can safeguard yourself from this? That is what is the topic for today's workshop. When I talk about Yog Nidra, first let me define what is the meaning of Yog Nidra. Now, Yog Nidra is basically is a combination of two words. Yoga plus Nidra, or Yog plus Nidra. Yog basically stands for union, confluence, or meeting. And when you talk about Nidra, Nidra stands for sleep in Sanskrit. So Yog is your union, Nidra is your sleep. So it's the confluence of your sleep, or the effect of your sleep, to enhance your health. Now, what way we can say that your sleep is one of the primest factor to influence your health? That is what we are going to determine over here. Now, first of all, let me tell you what exactly we are going to do. It's not that now you'll say talk, when you talk about the sleep, everybody is aware about like how many hours you need to be sleeping on an average and why sleep is important, why should you not ignore your sleep, and what is the, when you're sleeping, what are the benefits that like about the body derives when you have a sound sleep. So what is that different that I'm going to do it? I'm going to help you to determine the role of sleep over your mind. So see, whenever you talk about learning something, whenever you are thinking about choosing a particular option in your life, you want to learn something, first thing is that you need to learn to concentrate. You need to be alert, rather. Right? That means you have come here to learn something. If there would be lots of chaotic situation, there are a lot of people who are fighting over here, and loud music, and people who are coming here and there, so what would be the effect? You will get disturbed. And in that disturbance, what would happen? You would not be in a position to understand what am I trying to tell you. So the first reason, if you want to talk with somebody properly, you have a detail, you want to wind up or wrap up a deal, maybe just on the phone, everything is finalized, you just to finish it up on the phone, what do? You let all your office or all your professional people be out of your home or of your cabin so that you can talk to that particular person. Listen to what he's telling, and as you listen to what is his demand, you can mutually come to an agreeable point and just wrap up the deal. That is what the thing. So the bottom line, if I say you want to learn something, what you need to do is you need to be alert. You need to be wide alert or wide awake. Right? Because when you're wide awake, you can really be in a position to understand what is the demand or what is the other person's opinion. And when you are aware about the other person's opinion, you can take a decision accordingly. Right? And that's what we all do in any situation. So this work or this activity, which is primarily governed by your thinking ability, your rational behavior, ability in which you have to think, you have to understand, you have to analyze, you have to understand the whole scenario. This whole situation comes under the influence of what we call the conscious mind. Right? So conscious mind is the one which helps you to determine your daily activity. It helps tells you to take care of each and every situation where you need to take a decision or when you need to take a rational approach. Is that understood? But when you talk about a conscious mind, there are many things in our life which we do not think about, which we are not even aware about what way it does, like, you know, what way it is occurring. It just occurs and you are probably not even aware. By the time you realize that such a thing has occurred, you have already taken an appropriate action. And these things are basically come into three categories. So these things are basically governed by your feelings, emotions, and your memories. And all this comes from your that part of your brain which does not think, which does not have a rational behavior. It is like your autopilot system. It's like if you have kept your hand on a hot tawa, on anything which is hot. You don't think, oh God, I have put it over here, now I have to take it out. Much before that you realize what you have done, your hand has been automatically withdrawn. Right? The blood which is circulating in your body, the different actions in different scenarios, like when you face a very bright light, your eyes, your pupil gets contracted. When you face a situation when your light is very dim, then your pupil would be dilated. So right from a very small situation to anything which is really in a very tricky situation, all this runs under a system which is governed by your subconscious mind. So this subconscious mind is the one which is responsible for all the involuntary actions, and this is the one which controls your autonomic nervous system. So it has got a very direct and a very, very powerful effect, powerful role to play on your health, because this is the one which is linked with your emotions, which is linked with your feelings, and hence any event, any situation which has been linked with your emotion would always be in a position to control you or put a trail of action which would be important for you to control. Right? So now, why did I discuss, like, normally when people talk about Yog Nidra, just tell you about, okay, there is a procedure in which you have to sleep. But what is the need for you to go to sleep when you can sleep in your own house? In your own, like, you know, comfort of your own, like, bed and all. Here the reason is that when you're doing a Yog Nidra, it's not just an ordinary